is certainly difficult. But we cannot help it. Later on, perhaps, we shall have definite meanings on fixed days. At present, it is impossible to do this. People must show themselves in their evaluation of what they have heard. All this and much else besides still remained for me at that time half a loose question. But the lecture then, in general, all that she said at that time, both of the meetings and outside them, interested me more and more. On one occasion, at one of these meetings, someone asked about the possibility of reincarnation, and whether it was possible to believe in cases of communication with the dead. Many things are possible, said he. But it is necessary to understand that man's being, both in life and after death, if it does exist after death, may be very different in quality. Then, man-machine, with whom everything depends upon external influences, with whom everything happens, who is now one, the next moment another, and the next moment a third, has no future of any kind, he is buried and that is all. Dust returns to dust. This applies to him. In order to be able to speak of any kind of future life, there must be a certain crystallization, a certain fusion of man's inner qualities, a certain independence of external influences. If there is anything in a man able to resist external influences, then this very thing itself may also be able to resist the death of the physical body. But think for yourselves what there is to withstand physical death in a man who faints or forgets everything when he cuts his finger. If there is anything in a man, it may survive. If there is nothing, then there is nothing to survive. But even if something survives, its future can be very varied. In certain cases of solar crystallization, what people call reincarnation may be possible after death, and, in other cases, what people call existence on the other side. In both cases, it is the continuation of life in the astral body, or with the help of the astral body. You know what the expression, astral body, means. The existence with which you are acquainted and which use this expression state that all men have an astral body. This is quite wrong. What may be called the astral body is obtained by means of fusion, that is, by means of terribly hard inner work and struggle. Man is not born with it, and only very few men acquire an astral body. If it is formed, it may continue to live after the death of the physical body, and it may be born again in another physical body. This is reincarnation. on which were many duplicates and others having no particular value from an artistic point of view. During his visit, he had found that the price of garbage in Petersburg was higher than in Moscow, and every time he came he brought a bale of garbage which he sold in Petersburg. According to another version, he simply bought the carpets in Moscow at the Kolchka and brought them to Petersburg to sell. I did not altogether understand why he did this, but I felt it was connected with the idea of acting. The sale of these carpets was in itself remarkable. G put an advertisement in the papers and all kinds of people came to buy carpets. On such occasions they took him, of course, for an ordinary Caucasian carpet seller. I often sat for hours watching him as he talked to the people who came. I saw that he sometimes played on their weak side. One day he was either in a hurry or had grown tired of acting the carpet seller and he offered a lady, obviously rich but very grasping, who had selected a dozen fine carpets and was bargaining desperately, all the carpets in the room for about a quarter of the price of those she had chosen. At first she was surprised but then she began to bargain again. She smiled and said he would think it over and give her his answer the next day. The next day he was no longer in Petersburg and the woman got nothing at all. Something of this sort happened on nearly every occasion. With these carpets, in the role of traveling merchant, he again gave the impression of a man in disguise, a kind of Harun al-Rashid, or the man in the invisible cap of the fairy tale. Once, when I was not there, an occultist of the charlatan type came to him, who played a certain part in some spiritualistic circles in Petersburg and who later became a professor under the Bolsheviks. He began by saying he had heard a great deal about G and his knowledge and wanted to make an acquaintance in his mind. G, as he told me himself, played the part of a genuine carpet seller. With the strongest Caucasian accent in some of the Shashi, he began saying that there was an occasion and that he only ruled carpet.
Manner of the Nelda, 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 Manner of the Nel Maybe from time immemorial. And it's nearly me, the thoughts flash across my mind.
characteristics of materiality. Now, one of the first characteristics of materiality is that matter is always limited. That is to say, the quantity of matter in a given place and under given conditions is limited. Even the sand of the desert and the water of the sea is indefinite and unchangeable quantity. So that, if knowledge is material, then it means that it wants a definite quantity within a given place at a given time. It may be said that, in the course of a certain period of time, say a century, humanity has a definite amount of knowledge in its disposal. We know, even from an ordinary observation of life, that the matter of knowledge possesses entirely different qualities according to whether it is taken in small or large quantities. Taken in a large quantity in a given place, that is by one man, let us say, or by a small group of men, it produces very good results. Taken in a small quantity, that is, by every one of a large number of people, it gives no results at all, or it may give even negative results, contrary to those expected. Thus, if a certain definite quantity of knowledge is distributed among millions of people, each individual will receive very little, and this small amount of knowledge will change nothing either in his life or in his understanding of things. And however large the number of people who receive this small amount of knowledge, it will change nothing in their lives, and that long enough to make them still more invisible.
Just in